Grace and peace to you from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Lord, open our lips, and we shall sing your praise. We sing our first hymn. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. So we come to our prayers of penitence. Jesus Christ, risen Master and triumphant Lord, we come to you in sorrow for our sins and confess to you our weakness and unbelief. God of mercy, we acknowledge we are sinners. We turn away from the wrong that we have thought and said and done, and are mindful of what we have failed to do. For the sake of Jesus, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and help us to live each day in the light of Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon us. Pardon and deliver us from all our sins. Confirm and strengthen us in all goodness, and keep us in life eternal. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And so now, assured of God's forgiveness, we come to sing his praise as we say together the Gloria. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, Heavenly King, Almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Our collect for today. Almighty God, send down upon your church the riches of your Spirit, and kindle in all of us your countless gifts of grace. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Today's reading is from Genesis 25, verses 19 to 34. Jacob and Esau. These are the descendants of Isaac, Abraham's son. Abraham was the father of Isaac, and Isaac was 40 years old when he married Rebekah, daughter of Bethuel, the Aramean, of Paddan Aram, sister of Laban, the Aramean. Isaac prayed to the Lord for his wife, because she was barren. And the Lord granted his prayer, and his wife Rebekah conceived. The children struggled together within her, and she said, "If it is to be this way, why do I live?" So she went to inquire of the Lord, and the Lord said to her, "Two nations are in your womb, and two peoples born of you shall be divided. The one shall be stronger than the other. The elder shall serve the younger." When her time to give birth was at hand, there were twins in her womb. The first came out red, all his body like a hairy mantle. So they named him Esau. Afterward, his brother came out with his hand gripping Esau's heel. So he was named Jacob. Isaac was 6 years old when she bore him. When the boys grew up, Esau was a skillful hunter, a man of the field, while Jacob was a quiet man, living in tents. Isaac loved Esau because he was fond of game, but Rebekah loved Jacob. Once when Jacob was cooking a stew, Esau came in from the field, and he was famished. Esau said to Jacob, "Let me eat some of that red stuff, for I am famished." Therefore he called him Edom. Jacob said, "First sell me your birthright." Esau said, "I am about to die. Of what use is a birthright to me?" Jacob said, "Swear to me first." So he swore to him and sold his birthright to Jacob. Then Jacob gave Esau bread and lentil stew, and he ate and drank and rose and went his way. Thus Esau despised his birthright. Here ends the reading. Amen.
The Gospel reading today is taken from Matthew 13, verses 1 to 9 and verses 18 to 23, the parable of the sower. That same day, Jesus went out of the house and sat by the lake. Such large crowds had gathered around him that he got into a boat and sat in it, while all the people stood on the shore. Then he told them many things in parables. He said, "A farmer went out to sow his seed. As he was scattering the seed, some fell along the path. The birds came and ate it up. Some fell on rocky places where it did not have much soil. It sprang up quickly because the soil was shallow. But when the sun came up, the plants were scorched and they withered because they had no root. Other seed fell among thorns, which grew up and choked the plants. Still other seed fell on good soil, where it produced a crop, 100, 60, or 30 times what was sown. Whoever has ears, let them hear." Listen then to what the parable of the sower means. When anyone hears the message about the kingdom and does not understand it, the evil one comes and snatches away what was sown and what was sown in their heart. This is the seed sown along the path. The seed falling on rocky ground refers to someone who hears the word at once and receives it with joy. But since they have no root, they last only a short time. When trouble or persecution comes because of the word, they quickly fall away. The seed falling among the thorns refers to someone who hears the word, but the worries of this life and the deceitfulness of wealth choke the word and make it unfruitful. But the seed falling on good soil refers to someone who hears the word and understands it. This is the one who produces a crop yielding 100, 60, or 30 times what was sown. This is the gospel of our Lord. Thanks be to God.
We now say together our profession of faith. Do you believe and trust in God the Father? I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. Do you believe and trust in his Son, Jesus Christ? I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died and buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. Do you believe and trust in the Holy Spirit? I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. So now we come to our time of prayer, our prayers of intercession. Let us pray. Lord of the harvest, make us fruitful in good works. Help us to share in your salvation and enjoy bringing in your harvest. Through through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Your response after I say, God, you are our salvation, is, you are the hope of us all. We pray for those who go out to seek and save the lost. We are sorry for the times when we stray from you, when we are tempted to lose hope. God, you are our salvation. You are the hope of us all. We pray for all of those who have lost their jobs and their livelihoods. We pray for those who have unrewarding work to do and feel neglected. For all who are choked by the burden of care and anxiety. We hold up to you all who have lost hope and feel that they have nothing to offer. God, you are our salvation. You are the hope of us all. We pray for our homes, that they may be places where love and joy and peace abound. May we nurture the young in the ways of truth and goodness. We pray for the homeless and all of those who look in hope to have a home of their own. God, you are our salvation. You are the hope of us all. We pray for all of those who we love, especially those from whom we have been parted for so long. Protect and enfold them in your love. God, you are our salvation. You are the hope of us all. Amen. And so we come to our peace. Please, if you are at home with someone else, share the peace with them after this. If you are on your own, then I will wish you peace. Not an easy peace, not an insignificant peace, not a half-hearted peace, but the peace of the Lord Jesus Christ is with us now. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Father, you made the world and love your creation. You gave your Son Jesus Christ to be our Saviour. His dying and rising have set us free from sin and death. And so we gladly thank you, with saints and angels praising you and saying, Holy, 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 God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. We praise and bless you, loving Father, through Jesus Christ our Lord, and as we obey his command, send your Holy Spirit, that broken bread and wine outpoured may be for us the body and blood of your dear Son. On the night before he died, he had supper with his friends, and taking bread, he praised you. He gave it to them and said, Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. When supper was ended, he took the cup of wine. Again he praised you and gave it to them and said, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. So, Father, we plead with confidence, Jesus' sacrifice, made once for all upon the cross, bringing before you the bread of life and cup of salvation. We proclaim his death and resurrection until he comes in glory. Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Lord of all life, help us to work together for that day when your kingdom comes and justice and mercy will be seen on all the earth. Look with favour upon your people, gather us into your loving arms and bring us with Mary, Saint Nicholas and Saint Andrew and all the saints to feast at your table. Through Christ and with Christ and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory are yours, O loving Father, for ever and ever. Amen. We say together the words of the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Draw near with faith, receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which he gave for you, and his blood, which he shed for you. Eat and drink in remembrance that Christ died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. So I now invite you to take what it is you are using for your bread. The body of Christ. And now I invite you to take whatever it is you are using for your wine. The blood of Christ. So we sing now our second hymn.
Thank you.
we say our closing prayer. May we go as those whose cup of life runs over. May we go as those who have received the bread enough for others. May Christ Jesus host our every meal, and may the Spirit fill us with joy. Amen. And the blessing. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord protect and guide you. May his strength uphold you, his light shine upon you, his peace surround you, and his love enfold you. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen.